real. It's up and running. Got it going. Got it going on. All right, so this is what we're going to do today. Start out. If you guys don't know what's going on, I'm trying to beast it up over here on Full Flush. Full Flush is so soft. It's so ridiculous that I just make a bunch of money. And so, what I want to do is I want to be king of Full Flush. I mean, I want to like own the table. I want to be able to sit at like 5'10" and 10'20" and all this jazz. I almost got like a lot of money. So I'm almost trying to sit higher than I do. Right now I'm at 2'4", the highest. I was sitting 3'6" for a while. Probably start doing that again pretty ASAP. 5'10", probably pretty soon too. 10'20", maybe, I don't know, it just depends. I got some cash outs pending, so we'll see what happens. But what I'm gonna do is I wanna make sure that I'm beating people there, and I wanna be able to compete against the red, you know, that's kind of a crucial thing. So, what I'm gonna do today to start the session out, something a little bit different, okay? But while I'm doing that, I'm going to tell you guys what it is I plan on doing today. Yeah, dude. Cares, friend. Dude, he's looking pretty good, right? They're so fresh. Got it cut yesterday. Next time, I'm gonna let be all over that razor fade. Zero fade. Alright, so what we're gonna do now is, these are the guys that probably give me the most trouble. There's one guy named Just Your Luck who's on the site. He gives me a lot of trouble. He's aggro, man. He's like, but these guys are probably the guys that sit regularly to give me the most trouble. Mr. Bill and Mr. Gambling Man. Good shit, you know what? I forgot to like, Alright, so these are the guys that are giving me the most trouble, like I was saying. I'm losing my train of thought here. But these guys, Bill and Gamble Man, they're always sitting pretty good, the stakes they play. Or at least on this site, you know. I'm not sure how they do on Stars or whatever, but they're good. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go through this, and I'm going to, like, look at what they're doing. And I'm going to try and figure out how to beat them. And Gamble Man, oh, that's this game. All baits. He's winning it a lot. 2,500 hands. 8 EV per 100. And EVs. He's pretty damn good. Now what we're going to do is, we're going to take a look at his stats. I've never really done this for like regular games. I haven't done it in such a long time. I've reviewed certain specific players. Four tailing on one Monterey got his badass screen on the other. Dude, didn't sell me, I appreciate it. Kick some ass. Where are you playing at, man? I'll come back to sometime. So I'm going to take a look at Mr. Gamble Man's stats here. See what I can figure out. I think maybe, first of all, I'm going to take a look at the position. So we got the small blind, his D-tip is 23.6. That's way low. Big blind is 29.8. I think that's way low. What are mine? That's way low. You should be defending your big blind at come on. Mine's 46. I'm 26 defending small blind. People just don't defend their big blind often. 19 from early position, 19 from middle position, fair enough. 26.8 from cutoff, that's probably a little tight. I think better is in the 30, high 30s. What am I doing? Oh, I'm talking about, I'm thinking of unopened pots. So, 48%. Never mind. Still, I think I defend my big blind probably more than I should. Let's see here. Let's filter for unopened pots. Shall we? Take a look at that. I'm not a good one. Initial filter, carry position, whatever. Keep all the actions on open. Now let's check it over. So, cut off. Can I be a little bit looser from the cutoff? Probably. I think probably mid-30s is probably good from the cutoff. I think this is pretty bad, actually. I think I need to open up my cutoff. I created a chart somewhere. I'm not going to find it. How often I should be opening from everywhere. I got a big study on this. The button, 67%. Yeah, I think it's probably maybe a little low from the ground up. Probably a bit more, actually. I should probably start opening up a lot more. Almost 100%. Anyway, let's go again. 29% for small blinds. 19.4 in low position. Okay, 18.7 for the same. 28 for cutoff. 34 for the button. Yeah, so he's like crazy. Let's see about Mr. Williams here. I don't have a lot of energy. Bill, 19.9. Small blind's 52, that's much better. Early position is 11, so he's super tight under the gun. Fair enough. I mean, super tight. Now, what are we doing here? This is like, we don't have any hands on this. So, I don't know. But, 109 button position where it's unopened and he's still only 50%. Alright, now let's take a look at like what they're doing overall, some spots. Let's do we'll just do Gamble Man for now. We'll forget about Bill. Well, I'm nothing wrong with Bill, not nothing wrong with Bill. No, 1,000 hands. Yeah, we might have one. Let's focus on Gamble Man, okay? Oh my god, music time. Music hype! You think music is way too loud? My computer volume is like 4. Alright, let's turn this music down. Give me music feedback. Music volume feedback. I can't spell day. All right, so let's look at what Gamble Man's doing. All right. Good flop raise, VPIP. They look a little tight, but that's fine. 3-betting, 9%. Okay, that's probably pretty good, actually. Overall, went to showdown percent, 27.9. Why do I feel like that's low? Where am I at? 31. Yeah, it's not that low, though. Considering how tight he is, it should be higher. Because if he's that tight, he should be entering the pots with better hands more often. So it should be a little bit higher. Although it's not so off to where I'm really concerned. Aggression. Percentage is 25%. Frequency or whatever is 1.66. not as aggressive as I'm thinking. Steal from small blind. Flop c-bet percent is 40. Okay, cool. So he's not c-betting that much. And considering how tight his range is, I think he's probably checking back. Oh, now I know I've seen him check back top pairs before. So I think probably what I'm going to do... start... I'm going to probe. You guys know what probe is? That's like where somebody just micro on Bet Online just started playing poker about 2 months ago. I'm an accountant, so the numbers appeal to me. Dude, I'm an accountant. Well, I was an accountant. Like, I studied accounting at the University of Georgia, so... You can read about it on my About Me section of the Twitch stream. But, and also there's like, you can click on that About Me thing and you can see like where my blog is and kind of like read about some of the stories when I was traveling for a minute playing poker when Black Friday happened. So I didn't blog a lot, but it's funny. You know, I hear it's a pretty good blog.